We're going to look at some tips and tricks for shooting tabletop. Welcome to Pull My Focus, adventures in the world of digital filmmaking, where we give you the tips, tricks, and techniques you need to make great video. As filmmakers and videographers, at some point, you need to shoot an insert shot. Might be of a cell phone, a drink, or a client's product. And that means tabletop. Here's the first thing to know. Tabletop means you're getting in really close to what you're shooting, that you see everything. That means issues that normally aren't a problem start to show themselves, like scratched glasses or products with a crooked label, things you normally wouldn't notice. Look at your hero and backup props closely before you shoot. Clean them if you have to. And if needed, buy brand new products, checking to make sure they're not scratched or damaged in some way. You're looking to avoid issues that could steal the viewer's focus when you get in that close. Lighting tabletop is interesting because it's a microcosm for shooting on a full set. You still have a key light, fill, bounce cards, edge, and all that. It's just on a smaller scale. We'll cut up a few pieces of show card, white on one side, black on the other, and create little stands using cardboarded wedges. I move this card into place and there's my fill. But you'll notice the card also throws a reflection on this bottle. Heck, everything in the room is reflected in this bottle. Not a problem. Our show card is black on one side, remember, for negative fill. We'll make a few cards with the black side facing out. This will help us sculpt the look of the bottle by controlling its reflections. I'm using it to create a vertical line here. Now watch as I turn it. It catches some of the key light, maybe even goes a little more gray, and also it changes its width. I'll also add another white card, not for fill, but to sculpt it as well. As I twist it, it changes its width as well. You can also buy gray cards, which give you more options. You can pick up show card at any art store, and it's usually called art card or presentation board. Because you're close in on your subject, your depth of field becomes even shallower. This can look good, but if you need more depth of field, you may need to boost your light levels to shoot at a higher f-stop. One way to do that is to bring your lights in very close, or up your ISO. An advantage of shooting in close is you can use any surface you want to put the object on. If you need a reflective surface, a clear acetate sheet or plexiglass placed on top of white or colored paper will work. For certain shots, you may need to shoot in a light box, the tabletop version of a white psych stage. You can purchase light boxes that are basically mini pop tents. If you want, you can make a light box out of a plastic bin. Just put it on its side using paper or cloth to create the psych diffusion on the sides. And those are a few of the numerous tips and tricks that go into shooting tabletop. We didn't even get into things like how to use a dental mirror to make a spotlight on your subject, or how to deal with reflections and hot spots on shiny metallic and glass objects. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out the companion articles that go with our videos on pullmyfocus.tv, and check out our other videos on other aspects of production, post-production, and pre-production, like lighting liquids.